This video shows you how to calculate the effect size Eta² or F for in repeated measures won by ANOVA and SPSS. For the more meaningful effect size calculation for past hoc tests, please refer to the video linked in the description. Eta² or F is mostly used in the sample size calculation by other researchers within a similar setting. To acquire it in SPSS, go through the usual repeated measures ANOVA. Analyze, General Linear Model, Repeated Measures. Put in the name of your within subject factor and the number of levels if you haven't done it yet or have to start over. Don't forget to put your measurements into the within subjects variables box and then go to options and select estimates of effect size. Click continue and then OK to get to the results. You will see a repeated measures ANOVA being calculated and for general interpretation of it, check the linked video. This time your tables have an additional column called partial Eta². For the repeated measures ANOVA, you have to go down to the Tests of within subject effects table, and since its calculation is based on the sum of squares, it does not differ across the lines. In this case, the sum of squares of your within subject variable is divided by the sum of squares for the within subject variable plus the sum of squares of the error. The Eta² for my example is 0.238. This means that 23.8% of the variation in the fitness score is explained by the within subject factor time. Cohen shows the effect size F though, which means you have to transform Eta² to F. Thankfully, Cohen has the proper formula in his 1988 book on page 284. I can either do the calculation in Excel, Google Sheets or use the calculator. If you want the calculation to be as exact as possible, I would recommend using Excel or Google Sheets and copy the Eta² with all decimals available and do the calculation there. If I convert my sample partial Eta² to F, it is 0.559. If you want or need to classify the magnitude, refer to comparable studies or research field-specific thresholds first, and only use Cohen 92 when this is not the case. The thresholds given by Cohen on page 157 are 0.1, 0.25 and 0.4 for small, medium and large effects. Again, please keep in mind that effect sizes for past hoc tests are much more meaningful. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.